Today I want to talk about a very fun and interesting topic, one that gets overlooked a lot, and that is, are you setting yourself up for failure? Let's get started. Calorie levels that are just way too low, you will overtrain, you will just do more and more and more and more and more, but it's just gonna get to the point where your body is going to fight you, your body is going to resist what you're trying to do. What is up, YouTube? It's Christine with Gage Girl Training, an online meal planning and coaching service. And today I want to talk about a very fun and interesting topic, one that gets overlooked a lot, and that is, are you setting yourself up for failure? So let's get started. I consider myself to be a very, you know, the glass is half full as opposed to the glass is half empty type of person. But it comes to a point where you have to ask yourself if you're setting yourself up for failure when it comes to your health and fitness goals. I see it all the time with some clients who are extremely desperate to reach a certain goal. I appreciate the fact that people have a whatever it takes mentality, but there's a difference between whatever it takes versus a desperation that is only going to set you up for failure. So what's the difference? So the difference is, sometimes if you have a very time sensitive goal and you are willing to put yourself in a caloric deficit that is above and beyond going beneath your BMR. Your BMR is your basal metabolic rate. That is the minimal amount of calories your body needs to sustain your current lean muscle mass. And if you dip yourself below that for extended periods of time, I genuinely believe that you are setting yourself up for failure, because what's gonna happen is you will do great for about 2 weeks and a binge will be inevitable. So there are some of you who just will do anything and you'll put yourself on extremely low calorie levels. Calorie levels that are just way too low, you will overtrain, you will just do more and more and more and more and more, but it's just gonna get to the point where your body is going to fight you, your body is going to resist what you're trying to do. You're going to be miserable, you're going to be constantly weighing yourself and checking yourself and measuring yourself, and it's just not advised, guys. I genuinely don't advise setting goals that are so aggressive. I know I told you guys this before, but whoever said that you could drop 2 pounds of body fat per week, that's the absolute maximum that you can do. And honestly, if you are significantly overweight and or obese, that rate of fat loss drop is much more reasonable compared to somebody who has about less than 25 to 30 pounds to drop. So if you fall under that category, that rate of fat loss is probably going to be a little bit too aggressive for you, and you may need to just give yourself some more time. So if you have a lot going on in your life right now, meaning if you have other priorities outside of your health and fitness. So what do I mean, other priorities? If you have a demanding job, a demanding career, if you have a demanding household, if you are overcoming an illness, if you are dealing with somebody else in your family or household who has a serious illness that you have to care for, if you are dealing with financial struggles, if you are dealing with any of these types of things, giving yourself an aggressive weight loss goal, it's a recipe for disaster. Instead, I would encourage you to establish better habits. I would encourage you to get in a routine of exercising at least 3 times a week. 3 times a week may not sound like a lot. I'm always shocked when I ask people how many times a week they can commit to working out. People are like 7 days, 6 days. I'm gonna do it every single day. But it's like, I love the energy, I love the enthusiasm, but are you really going to work out out that often forever and ever? Probably not. So be more realistic. Focus on creating sustainable habits, guys. Don't put yourself in a situation where you're setting yourself up for failure, because what's going to happen is you're going to be miserable. You're not going to reach your goals. You're going to be probably going to binge even more and gain more weight. If you are also in a situation, maybe you're going back to school for something. Guys, it's hard. It's really hard to do it all. And I admire the effort. I think you should do your best to eat your best. I think you should do your best to be healthy and move. But I think adding that type of pressure on top of what you're currently doing is a recipe for disaster.